Wetlands are one of the most functional ecosystems on the planet. And there are many different types of wetlands around the world that provide many different functions, but they can all be defined as being partially covered for most or part of the growing season. They're also defined by the very unique organisms that have adapted to live here. Wetlands cover only 6% of the entire planet, yet they contribute over 40% of all ecosystem services, which is super impressive if you think about it. Just some of these services, which benefit both humans and wildlife, are recharging and storing water, as well as flood and climate mitigation, nutrient cycling and storage, especially carbon, which is very important for climate change, heavy metal storage, primary production, and critical provisioning of wildlife habitat. Unfortunately, in the past, wetlands have mostly been thought of as mosquito-filled wastelands. And because of this thought, we have lost at least 50%, if not a lot more, of wetlands worldwide. Fortunately, we saw the error in this and realized how valuable this ecosystem is to us. And because of that, there was a global treaty made to stop the loss of the remaining wetlands on Earth. Here in Utah, our wetlands are an extremely rare and very valuable resource to us. They cover only 1% of our entire land cover, and 80% of that 1% is here on the shore of the Great Salt Lake, where the fresh water from the mountains comes in to meet the saline water of our lake. And there are many different types of wetland habitats on the Great Salt Lake. To name them would be submergent marshes, emergent marshes, as we have here in the background, wet and salt meadows, and playa habitats. Submergent marshes can be defined as having a much deeper layer of water over the course of the year. And this deeper water helps to support submergent vegetation that is critical food for many different types of waterfowl and water birds. Not only does it support the submergent vegetation, but it also supports fish, which are very important for American white pelicans and grebes. Emergent marshes can be defined as having water covering them for most of the year, but at shallower levels, which allows plants such as sedges, reeds, and cattails to grow up through that water layer. Emergent marshes are extremely critical for many different species of birds. So wet and salt meadows are typically saturated through this growing season, and they support many different types of plant species. However, their soils are typically more alkaline or saline, so the plants that grow in them are able to better adapt to those conditions. And these types of habitats are really important for feeding birds, for foraging birds, as well as for providing cover and nesting habitat to many different waterfowl species, so they can have a little bit of cover from the sun or from predators. Playas are seasonally flooded, mostly during the spring and the fall seasons. The soils within playa are described as being heavily alkaline or saline. And because of this, not very many plants can grow on them. And in many times, they are completely barren of all vegetation. However, there are some plant species that have adapted to be able to handle the high salt or alkalinity. These plants include pickleweed, which is my personal favorite of the wetland plants, as well as saltgrass. Playa habitat, as well as the fringe salt-loving plants, are very important to wildlife species that use it for food and cover. Shorebirds especially love the playa when it is flooded and can feed upon the insects that are flying around the pickleweed, saltgrass, and open water. All of these different wetland habitat types and the plants that grow within them support many different species of wildlife, but most notably are migratory birds. Millions of birds every year traveling along the Pacific and Central flyways use the Great Salt Lake and its wetlands as a critical breeding, staging, and foraging area. If you get the chance and you find yourself wanting to see all of the beautiful wildlife, come visit the Great Salt Lake and its wetlands. Come learn about the amazing dynamics that are shared between the water, plants, and the animals. And take some time to discover all of the different functions and services that these wetlands offer to both us and our valuable wildlife.